All right, looks like we're live. Oh, welcome everybody to the Costume Quest DLC, Grubbins on Ice. Halloween's over, it's Christmas time.
Do I continue or do I start a new game for that?
Start a new game.
So it's not really DLC?
It kind of is.
Plot one isn't going to override my other one, right?
I don't think so.
Christmas candy!
So what would the Christmas version of popular Halloween candies be?
Candy canes.
Yeah.
That was a pretty dumb question, wasn't it?
There is already kind of Christmas candies, although not as many.
I mean, there aren't very many Halloween-specific candies, either.
That's true.
There's candy corn. The rest of the candy is just
candy. Candy. Or candy that can be color-coded to match the holiday. Red and green M&Ms.
Yeah, M&Ms for every...
Or just the wrappers. Rulos or Reese's. Shapes. Oh, aren't these two just adorable?
You don't know which character you picked in the main game, so they're not using either of them?
Not yet.
No, what did you do? Bye.
She fixed it.
Well, we're already down one character.
We gained two, which means we don't need to do anything.
So if it doesn't know which character you picked in the other file, and it gives Ren the robot costume by default here, does that mean that she is the canon main character?
I would say so. You would not have played this, Yami, because you had this on Xbox and probably didn't get the DLC for free, right?
I paid for it.
Oh, you did?
I bought DLC.
He spent his cold, hard cash.
Traded in all of my candy dollars.
Yes, all of your chocolate coins.
Oh god. How come when I move my finger, their costumes disappear, and they're just heads? That's horrifying. It keeps happening. Okay, stop the madness.
Oh god.
Oh jeez, that should not be happening.
No, that is quite the render error. I hope that goes away.
Please stop. There's not a whole lot of pointing that happens.
Yeah,
please stop
like
doing that now.
Get into that deadly vortex.
Not really deadly. I mean, you came out the other side just fine.
You don't know that.
Lucy's right there. She's okay.
You don't know she's okay. She hasn't said anything yet.
They're just showing her the ropes. She's going to be the new evil overlord.
The portal just barfs them out. Not him again. Oh no!
I guess you didn't kill Big Bones.
It's not.
You just banished him from your realm. Now Lucy is candy corn.
So they could magically... Oh, never mind.
I couldn't change my costume. I don't want Spaceman.
Too bad.
Right.
You got Spaceman.
Why are they level 14?
Because it's Christmas.
Yep. Oh, okay.
They got extra levels as presents.
I don't remember what the Spaceman's ability was.
It was that meteor thing.
Oh, right. The single target.
With, like, minor splash damage.
Ow!
Holy crap, they start with 1,000 health each.
That's a lot of health.
And I haven't been able to access a menu to, like, stamp for things.
Nope. You get damage up, and I don't even know, health up, and I don't know what the middle one is.
Oh, I see. They already
stamp
have
wise.
Things equipped.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice those.
I don't know what the eyeballs is though. It must be a passive buff though, because you don't have a B button ability.
Or, really? I could've used that poison damage. Jeez, I'm guessing I'm not supposed to win this.
It does seem a bit stacked against you.
Even if you're getting the successes, they're hitting for over 100.
And you have no healer. So it's
right.
Not like you can even pretend to, like, keep yourself alive. Well, you killed one of them.
The other two are on fire.
Additional fire! Oh, that did some splash damage? Probably does by default.
Yeah, it did like a tiny amount. Which is kind of weird, because it's like so little that it's pretty much pointless.
I feel like I'm doing decently well, considering how...
Yeah, it's in that weird spot where, like, you're not sure if you're supposed to win or not, because you're, like, almost winning. A night shield lasts for more than one turn, which I'm surprised.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
That makes it, like, not complete trash. I guess it's just 2 turns.
Apparently.
And I doubt it's like number of attacks or anything.
And you're dead.
Saw that coming.
It was respectful.
But yeah, that was like really close.
Yeah, I wasn't supposed to win.
Yeah. It's like too close though. Like it should be stacked even more against you so that you're like certain that it's like nope, can't win this.
Right.
That almost feels like if you did it like absolutely perfectly, there'd be like a chance you could win or something.
If you were really lucky.
Yeah. Like if they split their damage to keep so that all of your guys stayed alive as long as possible.
Right.
And like when you use the guardian shield, they all only attacked the person that had the shield up.
Yeah.
Well, you fell on those guys and killed them anyway.
Oh, splat.
Time to go back to smacking things for candy.
Yeah, you start with your bat bucket and everything. You don't start with your excess experience, though.
Nope.
Just start at normal level 10 amounts.
Oh.
A Grubbin Revolution.
The assumed that was going to be a fight. Now I kind of feel like a jerk.
Just going around smacking random people with your candy pail?
Yeah, I mean, that's what they taught me to do in the real game. Rip cave.
Oh, you could check your stamps and see if you have other stamps.
Oh, true.
And costumes. I don't know if it just gives you these three.
Nope, it gives them all of them, it looks like.
So you can get your setup back to the way it was.
Oh yeah, and I have all sorts of stamps. Alright, so... Ren was the robot, Everett was the ninja, and... I guess it's Reynold now can be the unicorn.
I mean, if you had a little brother, wouldn't you dress him in a unicorn costume?
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, that's what you do with little brothers.
And Ren had the counterattack. Reynold had the... the rotten egg. And then Everett had the splash damage.
Yeah. Unicorn had the regen in the boss battle, but for standard use, I think you had the egg.
Yeah. So there's only going to be three new costumes, and one of them was spoiled for me by reading the achievements.
Right. It's only like one chapter, so...
Yeah.
There's a whopping 9 quests.
The... good for you. Okay. You guys are useless. Yeah, okay, that's the costume I knew about.
And spoilers over.
Yep. Yeah, more stamps. Deviled egg.
Oh man, even better.
Damages and applies a fire dot. Heck yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Need more candy.
There's 8 new stamps and you gotta get them all. Or else. Oh man, is that river made of ecto-cooler?
It's made of something. Maybe it's made of Mountain Dew.
What was the green juice in,
I doubt it's science.
Did I not hit that worm? There we go. Hit that worm. There was a smashy thing. I don't know what it was. Box. And it doesn't have an eye patch in it. The kid who's hiding.
It's not like these chests will all have the parts of the costume that you happen to have the blueprint for.
Nope.
Never.
I got an eyeball. Wait, that was a pattern. I don't want to be an eyeball.
Why don't you want to be an eyeball?
It's horrifying. Ah. Oh, cool. Not expect to go there. No going on an adventure.
Ooh.
Did you accidentally ramp?
It wasn't really a ramp.
It was kind of a ramp, just in the down direction. And then you fell off, and then you fell off again. Guess you're not getting back up that way.
Nope. Guess my partners aren't coming with me. Ooh, mushrooms.
Oh, you fell too far down or something? You fell, like, past that one platform.
Well, there was a smashy thing, so I thought the smashy thing was going to be a secret.
Yeah. Could be. Well, I don't remember.
You already found the secret cave.
That's true. Are there two ways to go here, or just...
Oh, man. Tracksuit.
Oh, no, there's two directions. I don't know which way is progress.
Yes.
Trick, they're both progress.
I'm gonna guess left dumps you back out on that slightly higher platform, and then you drop back into the cave.
This looks like somewhere I'm gonna go back in, where the right path takes me before I fall down a way that I can't get back up.
Oh. Maybe? Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure you'll loop back around eventually and be able to make a second pass anyway.
Yeah. Oh, there's stuff up there. Alright, so that's a dead end.
Yay, dead ends. You haven't run into any dark corridors, have you? Where a flashlight would come in handy. Secret cave.
Oh, that was the secret cave, but that wasn't the thing that I thought was the secret cave. Right? Go right.
So wait, you went down and then you went into a cave and came out at the top of the place?
Yes.
You never went up while you were inside the cave.
Nope. Only I had a hook. Possibly also a blade. What would we call that?
Blade hook?
A hook shot.
A claw shot to me, because I've only played Twilight Princess.
Congratulations on playing the worst Zelda.
Double claw shot?
We ran out of ideas. Here's a thing you already had.
It's not the worst Zelda as long as Spirit Tracks exists.
We don't talk about Spirit Tracks.
We're talking about it right now.
No, I'm not.
You can't make me.
Hey, now I'm bigger than houses. I think each of these have gotten progressively larger.
Oh, you've been bigger than houses. You're bigger than the entire mall.
It's true.
And a Ferris wheel.
True.
Now they only have half as much health as before.
Yeah, this is looking a little better.
And you can hit all of them.
More reasonable level.
How about that new Pokemon demo?
Oh boy.
Checked it out at all?
Yeah, I've been playing the demo. There was a sweet new trailer today, though.
I saw. can't believe it's firefighting again.
It's not, though.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. It's fire dark.
You're actually going to get there to be like, psych.
Just kidding. It's a heel Pokemon. It's a bad guy wrestler.
Yes. Cat. The other two.
It's amazing.
The other two also turn into firefighting.
All three of them. Every Pokemon in the game is actually firefighting.
Yes.
Can't knock on this door. Fine. I have a feeling these little green gobs of goo are going to be important.
Probably not.
Maybe they're just green gobs of goo.
Yes, they could be.
Maybe that's what the river is made out of.
Also possibly true.
You could go buy that stamp now.
That one was an actual fight. I was trying to talk to him. I felt bad about it immediately, assuming I should attack things with my bucket.
Nope. The like guards are the bad guys, and the normal Repugians are just like the citizens.
Yeah.
Covert members of the rebellion.
Yep.
You will ever see stunts? My French is terrible.
No, it's definitely a rebellion, not a resistance.
Oh, okay.
This Altaria, or whatever her name was, isn't invading. She's already in power. Actually, she's probably got legitimate mandate to rule. This might even be a coup, more than anything.
Coup's true?
No, that would be silly.
I'm a unicorn. I think this is already silly.
Unicorns are serious business.
They are. Especially when they have rainbow armor.
What? Where did you... I...
If only this game had dual techs, you could have the ninja, like, ride the unicorn.
My god.
And do a sweet combo move.
That would be amazing. Would it be a ninja corn, or would it be a uni-ninja? Kinda like ninja corn.
But if it was ninja corn, you wouldn't be able to differentiate it between the combo attack that the ninja gets with the candy corn.
That's a very valid concern.
Well, you just do it the other way for the candy corns. Then the candy corn and the unicorn would be
corn-a-corn?
Candy corn. It would either be a candy corn or a unicorn.
Gotta be a corn-a-corn.
Unicandy?
Yes.
I don't know. I don't want only one candy. I want lots of candy.
I kinda like
unicandy. That's why it's so scary!
Ah!
Hey, I can move now.
Overrated.
A ramp!
Best DLC.
It has ramps.
And Maple Crusties.
Tony Hawk's Pro Costume Quest.
And what's Tony Hawk been doing these days?
Eating.
Oh.
It's a dumb question.
Okay, so that guard implied that they became in power due to a revolution.
Maybe it's just an endless cycle of revolutions.
Oh, I mean, revolutions just mean cycle. Just,
yeah.
Yeah.
It's a revolution of revolutions?
Yeah.
But is it really a revolution if that's the standard way to transfer power?
Nobody has attacked the robot. I didn't put the counterattack on the robot, right?
Yeah, they know.
Yeah.
making up for them always going after the robot last time. There we go.
Yeah. See, that was the luck that I was having when I played the game, so I was just like, okay, not using the counterattack then. Let's go with something else. I think I just had, like, the damage up. Or maybe the, like, heavy poison or something.
Aha, uh-huh, he can't grow a beard.
Hmm. Yeah, this is gonna bug me now.
Was that card just cotton candy?
Was it cotton cleaver?
It was cotton candy.
Oh, cotton? Okay.
Yeah.
So if revolting is the standard way to transfer power, would a real revolution be a fair and free election?
Yes.
I mean, I'm gonna have to knock this game down a couple points. Clearly don't go into the socio-political implications of...
Candy.
Yes, candy.
Well, you just dress up as Lady Liberty and then have Abraham Lincoln's disembodied head come and debate for you.
Against the eagle?
Yeah.
No, the eagle's a moderator.
Oh, okay.
Go off topic, he claws your face off.
Fair and unbiased.
Yeah. As long as you stay on topic, the eagle will not claw your face off.
Hammer throw looks really painful.
Oh, YouTube has a sense of humor. It did pick the Lady Liberty image as the default preview image for episode 2.
I saw that. That was amazing. It just showed up in my feed, and I was like, oh man, best thumbnail ever.
You didn't even choose it.
No, it wasn't even like one of the options. It was the default.
It probably was like, this was the single image that was on the screen the most this video.
I'm guessing it just picks, like, even third timestamps to determine those.
Strawberry Smackdown.
That sounds like it should be a special move. Oh, hey, you're level 11 now. Isn't that just peachy?
Do you have elite 1000 XP? I think you had 13.
I do.
37000.
Man,
or 7, yeah. Elite 100.
There are ramps all over the place.
Litu.
So you're really just soliciting donations here.
Yep.
Yeah, you're getting candy donations for the revolution or resistance or whatever it is.
All right.
Araxia is her name. Ask your doctor if Araxia is right for you.
Second try.
Don't You're getting better.
Stamps.
You have enough for both now.
Dude, I was making my way this way.
Oh yeah. When you said about the ramp, you were headed to the right on my screen, so I thought you were continuing to go to the right.
Our one of three.
Yeah. You can almost be a pirate.
Almost.
I'm guessing the last pirate piece is behind that ramp on the right.
The last pirate piece is a bottle of rum. Wait a minute. Root beer barrels?
Full of rum.
Yep.
Where was the person that sold the stamps? Oh, it was the shady guy outside.
Shady Sadie?
His name is actually Shady.
Instead of Sadie?
Oh, but now there's four damps.
No.
Yeah, they're unlocked by you. They're unlocked by you leveling up.
Ah. Increased defense and causes damage to attackers.
That seems decent. That seems like counterattack, except you don't have to time the defense.
That's two different stamps.
Yeah, but still. Like, causes damage to attackers. Depending on, like, how much damage it does. If it does less, then it would make sense if it did less, because it's like, you don't need to time it, but it does less damage. But we can see. And I feel like if you give the flaming egg or whatever, the deviled egg, to the unicorn, then there's really no reason to ever auto-attack with the unicorn. Just keep throwing eggs at people.
Eggs forever. Are they unicorn eggs? Missed.
Maybe?
Ramp. It's a newspaper. I'm a pirate.
A newspaper pirate.
I'm going to say, are pirates normally up to date on current affairs?
I get out of here?
Maybe it's just an addition. Maybe it's just an addition of pillaging monthly.
I expected there to be a hook.
You got the hook.
I know. Well, there's a... Oh, there's just a pile of dirt over there.
Well, they can't guarantee you that you got... This was the last piece you got.
Yeah. Now that looks like a spot I might be able to fall down.
Do it. Let gravity win.
I'll fight that guard.
Try jumping.
Try guard? He was up that like wooden walkway.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna head that way later. After I see if I can fall down this hole. I can.
Okay.
There's a chest. Got
amazing chest ahead.
Got crappy paper.
You should just add Dark Souls message system into every game.
Try jumping. Amazing chest ahead.
Dry horse butthole.
Can you say that?
Yes.
Oh.
Back at the secret cave.
Don't give up, skeleton.
That is the best.
That was the best.
I missed skeleton messages in 3.
Did nobody have skeleton messages in 3?
I think there was like one.
Wasn't there like an entire skeleton cave in 3?
Yeah, and giant bone orb.
Yes. Skeleball.
If only we had a hook. Guys, I just did it.
Yeah, but only if you had a hook.
But I already...
Wee.
Already did it. Ooh, there's two.
Well, they don't have a hook.
Yeah, true.
Somehow they were able to come along with me.
They just followed.
Oh man, the mother load in here.
Did you find the secret cave? Well, the actual secret cave.
I think I did. Eyeball!
Can you be an eyeball now?
I am an eyeball. I'm an eyeball
right
now.
But you have to be a pirate.
I do.
You have to try them both in combat.
Apparently, the eyeball can see.
That's typically what eyeballs do, yes.
That is so many costumes. Okay, Everett can be the pirate. I'll be the eyeball. Boink. I miss my robot powers.
I mean, they're not gone for good.
I know.
They're gone until you try the eyeball in combat and then go, nope, and go back to the robot.
You gotta go across 5 different zip lines.
Yep, that's why I went back for that one. Oh, there's this hiding child and a guard.
What do you think your candy pail's gonna upgrade to this time?
Just a bucket. Just a 5-gallon five-gallon Home Depot bucket.
God, that's horrifying. Not the 5-gallon bucket, the eyeball.
The big flying eyeball, like out of Castlevania or something. And the pirate, obviously skeleton pirate.
Yeah, not Dead Men Tell No Tales is a pretty awesome attack.
Not Niagara Falls, which is apparently the eyeball's special attack.
I don't want to know what that is. It just cries on you.
Oh, pirate did quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, you did. I might actually stick with pirate, depending on what Dead Men Tell No Tales is. He also says R, just as an idle animation.
Well, I assume Dead Men Tell No Tales is they just sit around in a library reading silently.
Niagara Falls.
Oh man,
I was right.
I can't wait till 10 seconds are up and I get to see what it is.
That was hysterical.
You didn't really tell what it did because it just murdered the last guy.
I mean, I guess you could. The skeleton got a rose out of nowhere.
Who? The king.
There's a lot of costumes.
Nope, okay. Oh god, I'm standing in it. I guess it's fine.
No, your feet are dissolving.
I can't get out? There we go.
King Skellyman?
That's just a guard, I think.
I don't think it's anything.
You've not talked to any of these people?
No. I mean, I can talk to them, but they're just kind of there.
So you need a side dish.
Of eyeballs.
Yes, you need food.
I mean, I could be the French fries.
Why wouldn't you?
Because pirate.
French fry crab.
Eat fruit. There we go.
And a little difficulty.
Well, I didn't think that was going to be the solution because it didn't have the chicken leg over it.
I guess they only have the chicken leg when you are the fry costume.
Yeah, I don't remember where I'm supposed to bring her. Figure it out. Oh, maybe it's... Yeah, it was that guy, wasn't it?
Maybe you have to bring her back to the secret cave and kidnap her.
It's gonna be the sad old guy who's heartbroken.
Oh.
Slowly walking.
Yep. Slowly being delicious.
Well, not right now. Now I'm a pirate. Arr.
Oh, okay.
And now I'm
sea monsters probably think pirates are delicious.
True.
Well, this isn't the Sea Monster DLC. Now, is it?
No, because it froze over and it's on ice, apparently. There's not a lot of ice here.
No.
For it being on ice.
Yay.
Now you can go trick-or-treat farther.
How am I doing? One more costume. Bunch more stamps. I can afford one more stamp.
Yep. Gotta get all those creepy treat cards.
Yeah, there's an awful lot of them missing. Still have like twice as many houses to trick or treat at. Oh, I need an extra cotton candy.
Oh boy. I'm sure you'll find it. It's kind of weird that it's like, you have to have a duplicate one when it's like, well, I'm gonna get it. Like, it's not right. Like they're random drops or anything. I'm pretty sure you just always get them all.
Should not have gone back for Shady.
Oh.
Ah! Something clipped through me while I was trick-or-treating.
At least they didn't disappear constantly.
Eyeballs. Additional eyeballs.
Pirate's counterattack animation is pretty good. And his attack animation. Oh yeah, roses. Oh, I got a cotton candy. That.
Well, now you can give that guy a cotton candy. And you got maple crusties. Because that's just an appetizing name.
Aww. Wait, I still... Guard this!
Yeah, we still haven't seen the pirate special attack.
Yeah, so I'm keeping him in.
And he does seem like he might just be like an upgraded ninja, depending on what the attack does. I mean, Right. Honestly, the ninjas was a defensive move anyway.
Right, yeah, and I didn't use the shroud that often. It might be worth it for like a boss fight.
Right. You could have pirate and ninja.
True. I wonder what the counterattack would do. No, you can't. But you can't have two stamps. Ah. Zoomed in on one of the guys I was beating up for no reason.
Dynamic camera angles.
Oh yeah. That was rather sudden.
controversy with the pirates.
Nope. They die too fast.
You are too good at the murders.
This is what I do best.
Rainbow whips.
With a Z, so you know it's cool.
Yeah.
The hook is on fire. I'm feeling pretty good about that.
Your sneaking skills need some work, huh?
Yep. Their staying alive skills need some work.
Oh, burn.
Yeah, I went there. There you go. Now they're back to attacking the robot.
Yep. All the counterattacks.
Good.
They just can't resist his shiny blue exterior. I had to try really hard not to say posterior. I feel that joke is somewhat inferior.
I got nothing. Yeah, level up again.
Yeah.
Even more murder.
Even more stamps, probably.
Yep.
Fancy dollops. That doesn't sound like a good candy.
No. Where to next?
Well, some trick-or-treating to do.
You have 666 candy before you went to that house. Proof. Candy is the devil.
Yep.
Come on, balloon. I can hit it. There we go.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Exploded. No, it's a spooky, scary monster! Now that I leveled up again, there's gonna be another 2 stamps.
Yep, probably.
So, the previous house implied that there was a council of elders in charge before Traxia took over. So it's an oligarchy.
So are we trying to get the council back in power?
Yes, so we are. Yes, so I revised my previous statement. We are definitely. I don't know. Depends on how recent this overthrow was. If this was recent, then yes, we would be joining the resistance.
Resisting the revolution. Wow, it did a lot. The pirate attack did a lot of damage.
Yeah.
Like, man, it did 120. That's a lot. I realized that was just the splash attack.
Yeah, the main one was like 198. Oh man, are we gonna get to see the pirate move?
Yeah.
Oh man, I can't wait. I mean, I have to.
Look at all that cash monies. Oh, pirate cannons! It's an AoE attack!
Yeah!
Pirate's the best.
Pirate wins.
Pirate is the best.
Yeah. greatly increased defense, double attack power.
Oh god, give that to the pirate.
Yep.
Yes.
And just give the splash damage to someone else.
I'm gonna give the splash damage to the unicorn because I am not using the egg. Leave the counterattack on Ren. The Black Rose sounds interesting. I'm gonna put that on instead of the counterattack.
Just to see
how strong it is.
Yeah.
I feel like if it's DLC, the new stamps are probably drastically improved.
Possibly. The rest of them seem improved.
Yeah. And there weren't even defense ones before.
Yeah, because they gave you increases defense, and then a level later, greatly increases defense.
Yeah.
The guy in the robe's gonna want something.
Yep.
Is it the meat of delicious children?
Fruit meat? Meat fruit? What was that? Need a side dish to go with his meat fruit?
I think it was meat fruit.
I mean, is that meat that grows on trees?
Maybe, that would be awesome.
But would it still be meat then?
I mean, you can refer to, like, the fleshy part of fruit as meat.
True.
Pirate did 341 damage.
Oh god!
Just a love machine. And by that I mean murder. Murder machine. He also loves murder.
So I don't see what the Black Rose is doing.
It's hurting them when they hit you. And like the exact time that you take damage, they take damage too.
Okay.
But it doesn't seem to be nearly as much damage as the counterattack. Like they hit you for like 100 something, and then it for like 108 or whatever, and it hit them back for like 26 or something.
Oh. Yeah, I'll probably switch that back off.
It's basically just an easy way to get the counterattack thing, because you don't have to succeed the defense.
Still did 300 damage and I missed the attack up. Where's the counterattack?
Bubble onions.
Nom nom.
That what the giant floating eyeball used?
Maybe. Do you think they taste like onions, or are they just like onion-shaped candy that have like, you know, fruit flavors or something?
Why don't you try it out and report back?
I went
out. It's like Repugian candy or something.
Bubble onions.
Oh.
They have like onion and garlic flavored candy or something.
Oh, fine.
I have no idea what you're O-finding about.
I got tricked into walking on rickety catwalks.
I mean, you've been doing that anyway.
Yeah. I was all like, wee, and punching them. Ramps. Oops.
Ramp followed by oops.
Let's see how this turns out.
Don't
there needs to be a ramp
there.
that just launches you into the pit, just off the cliff. Like, oh man, sweet, a ramp! I wonder where... Oh! You just die.
And they were never heard from again.
The game is like, what did you think was gonna happen?
Ooh, I got an achievement. But I don't know what for. I came into a cave.
Oh, that's probably the secret stacking cave. Are there Russian nesting dolls?
There are.
Yes, that was a teaser for their next game, stacking.
Ah.
Which is also awesome. That was a really fun game. Apparently they just made it again and called it Headlander.
Oh, yeah. It's a commercial. Ooh, I found a thing. You can stop showing the message now. I left the room. There we go.
They needed to make sure that there was enough time for you to read it.
And buy their game.
Buy it. Buy the game. Buy it now.
Buy it now!
I feel like I may have gone the wrong way.
I mean, the secret's not necessarily the wrong way.
There's another door that wasn't the door that I came out of. They said they needed me to walk on rickety catwalks.
I think they were next to the big gate.
Oh, that could be.
And that guy said you need explicit permission to...
Yeah.
Go that way.
I just said, please move, and he moved. Oh. Why didn't you try that last time?
He did, and he was like, no. We're special.
Very respectful, Traubog.
Well, you did. You told him that the Elder sent you.
Lightly.
You didn't know that there was an Elder last time you talked to that guy.
So the hook glows like red hot while you're sliding down that, and the other two are just using their hands.
Yep.
Ancient cave carving. I'm pretty sure it means go to the right.
I don't know.
Now again, I don't know if that means that that's progress, or if I should go the other ways.
Yeah, I feel like this is just one of those, if you go the wrong way, you end up at the start things.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it said the Cave of Confusion, so... Oh, but it's dark and scary over here, so... Nope, not scary. There's falling rocks.
Ah, that's a very important distinction.
Falling rocks can be scary.
Yes, but a flashlight will not help you.
No. I like how you use it to walk into the doorway, and then it's just like, okay, and you just put it down and automatically run forward.
But it's something like you solved feels the puzzle. Different now. Cave on the right is... Get out. Oh, but there's so many directions to go.
How will you ever find all the things?
That was worth a try, though. I'm gonna guess this way, because that way has the falling rocks again.
Oh yeah, eyeball was worth a try. I'm sure it'll come in handy at some point.
Yeah, see, now it's going to be handy, because now the middle of this room is completely... If only we had... Oh, wait, now they're saying a bright light. I'm going to try eyeball anyway, though, just to see. Oh! Spaceman.
Space eyeball.
Yes, I want to be space eyeball.
It's just an eyeball with, like, an astronaut's helmet on. I mean, you could kind of see the symbols with the eyeball, but...
Yeah, but not like the symbol center. Was in the middle.
Yeah.
And it's still kind of hard to see.
Yeah, really.
This one has a symbol and a candy corn. But the candy corn is pointing at a different symbol.
I think that's... I don't think it's an arrow in that room, it's just...
It's just the symbol.
They worship candy corn.
This looks correct, because...
Exterminate them. Exterminate their entire religion.
No one worships candy corn on your watch.
Kill their priest, burn the churches. Hunt every
you
last.
Just give me the candy corn. Or is the one on the left open now? Yep.
Hunt every last adherent to the ends of the earth.
150 pieces of candy.
That's a significant amount of candy. Now you must solve more nefarious puzzles.
This is actually kind of interesting for the DLC, because the main game didn't really have a lot of puzzle rooms. It would have like one or two like progression blockers where it was just like, use the shield to get through this hallway. This is actually like, you need the spaceman so you can see, but then you also need to like figure out what the symbol is and then go into the correct door.
Yeah, it looks at least a little more interesting than get costume, use costume.
Yeah, except now I'm accidentally the knight.
Oh well.
Start over.
I'm sure the pirate can handle the entire fight by himself.
Yeah, probably.
I'm confused. Do they suddenly eat children now?
Maybe. Well, they dress the children up like candy corn. And then feed them to Big Bones?
Yeah, but that guard was implying he was going to eat you.
I think they said that in the base game at some point too, because they say that they're like delicious looking human or something.
Maybe.
So I guess maybe like they're supposed to give all the candy to Big Bones, but they probably like eating it themselves, and since humans are delicious candy, that they turn into delicious candy corn humans. I don't know.
There's just way too many inconsistencies in this game. I mean, I expect more attention to be paid to the deep lore of Costume Quest.
I thought you were going to say there's many inconsistencies. For instance, candy corn is definitely not delicious.
Well, I mean, that's just a glaring mistake on their part.
Error.
Yes. I don't know, maybe in this world they have a different kind of candy corn?
Maybe.
It's not made out of wax and crushed hopes.
Maybe Refugians really like eating wax and crushed hopes.
It's their staple food.
Yup. That's why humans are so delicious.
They're full of wax and, well, they're full of crushed hopes, that's for sure.
I mean, you have earwax.
Well, they wouldn't be raiding suburbs, though. They'd be, you know, raiding office buildings.
But the suburbs are where those people live. See, when you're at work, you're too engrossed in the work, because you're like, oh man, I gotta get this done. When you get home, and you don't have any time to do anything that you want to do, because you had to be at work all day, that's when the hope really gets crushed.
I don't know, I mean, when you're still at the office at 8:30, and your kids don't remember what you look like, and your wife is sleeping with the postman and the UPS guy at the same time. I think that's when it really sinks in.
Sorry.
What? Are you sleeping with the postman and the UPS guy at the same time?
Who brings the packages into the house?
Me?
Who brings the mail into the house?
Me?
There you go.
Well, the postman's just so dreamy.
I don't know, we're never home.
You are on Fridays.
True. The mail comes at like 9 o'clock. You think I'm out of bed?
If I had a webcam, you'd all be able to see me glaring at her. But I don't, so you'll just have to imagine it.
He's glaring. Quest complete.
Huzzah.
Three more kids and eight more houses. And a couple more quests.
Yep. Probably another creepy treat card duplicate quest.
Yeah. I got...
There's usually like two or three of those.
I'm really lost in this area.
Well, I think now you can go through the door where the trial bag was.
There we go.
It's a bit less linear of an area.
Yeah. Now it's snowy.
Well, you're climbing up the mountain.
Mount Repugia?
Probably.
They're not very creative.
Mount Candy Corn?
That was going to be my suggestion.
I mean, if it's snowy on the top and kind of orangey fall colors in the middle.
Big Corn Candy Mountain?
Is it like yellow on the bottom? What would be, is it like covered with like sunflowers or something at the bottom?
Slime mold.
I don't remember, but if they like zoom out at some point near the end of this and it is just a big mountain that's colored like candy corn, we totally called it. And if it's not,
then that's
they
a wasted have. Opportunity.
Yeah.
I used to believe in Tim Schafer.
Everyone did. I mean, Psychonauts is so good.
They made Broken Age and Massive Chalice, and it's just... why?
I think most
of
the...
Is he also the one that did Brutal Legend?
Yes.
Yes. That was an okay game. It wasn't amazing, but it wasn't terrible.
Didn't know what it wanted to be.
Yeah. It was like kind of sandboxy, like go around and do do mini objective things, but then like the battles were that weird like real-time strategy but also action combat. Like what? It was interesting, but it was kind of ridiculous.
And it was like super goofy and over the top for like the first two thirds. And then after that there was like that huge tone shift and everything's super dark and serious.
Yeah.
It's like... weird.
But I think most of the fallout over Broken Age was more not about the game itself, but more about the whole, like, releasing it in two parts and it taking forever to come out and stuff. I think most people who actually played both parts after they were out didn't have really... a problem with the game itself. At least not that I heard, anyway.
The only thing I heard was the ending kind of sucked.
Uh-oh. Could be. Well, we'll all just have to see how good or crap Psychonauts 2 is in, like, 30 years.
Guys!
I see it.
Bobbing for eyeballs.
Oh, that's worse.
Yellow eyeballs are rare and worth more points, and you don't want to bite the ones with pink eye.
No. That's a good life tip.
Don't bite the ones with pink eye?
Yeah. Is that not a good life tip?
I tend to avoid...
Do you want to bite the ones with pink eye?
Then you'll get pink mouth.
Aren't most people's mouths already pink on the inside?
That's the worst part. You'll never know if you have it.
Oh, no. I assume these are, like, candy eyeballs.
Yeah, the guy said they were.
Wouldn't want to encourage impressionable young children to be eating eyeballs.
For yourself.
You did it.
Yeah.
Just two more times now.
Yep. I know the drill.
That's kind of how this DLC kind of gets away with repeating everything all over again, because at least they try, like, different spins thematically.
Right.
So even though it's a little repetitive, you're like, oh, it's silly, it's eyeballs this time, okay.
Could use some more yellows, guys.
Getting new costumes is always fun too, just seeing like what they decided to add as a costume and seeing what its abilities are and what it looks like both in and out of combat. Did you fail?
I didn't feel like I did that badly. I feel
no,
like
no, they didn't give you like any yellow ones. Like, I don't know if you could have won that one. No, did you eat the pink eye?
Oh god, and then it like threw me off my rhythm.
Oh yeah, everything's dropping in right as you get there.
This is it, this is what we're doing for the rest of the night.
Yep. This is where the run ends.
Was not the urn.
I was over it. Aye, aye, aye. Very funny. There we go.
Now you got your eyeball groove back.
Then I smash it.
Yep. Mean. It works.
It's letting you play for free. Don't break his stuff.
But you gotta do it again!
Yeah.
Of course.
And probably get 45 points.
Probably. Yep. You guys need to keep the commentary going. I gotta focus on eyeballs.
It's too much eyeballs. We can't handle the eyeballs.
They've set the stream to restricted content.
Doesn't eyeballs seem like more of a Halloween themed thing anyway?
Than apples.
I mean, you're effectively in Halloween Town. Except without all the wonderful music numbers.
Yeah.
I guess you're kind of more in Christmas Town.
It's just Christmas in, or it's winter in Halloween Town.
Which is just Halloween again. Every holiday is just Halloween.
Yes.
Wiggly Woozers.
Yeah.
What's a woozer?
Yes.
And why are they wiggly?
Electroshock therapy.
Oh.
Man, they're trying to have a festival and you're smashing all their balloons.
Yep.
Maybe it'll help the Yeti come out.
Maybe he doesn't like the balloons.
Everyone likes balloons.
Maybe you'll get a Yeti costume and then you'll just walk out of the cave and be like, "Whoa, I'm the Yeti!"
That is entirely possible. So good on sneaky hide and seek kids.
No, you need two more, three more?
Two more.
They must be pretty sneaky this time.
Must be.
That newspaper hat is just great.
I know.
There's like actual text for the entire, like you could read every little thing on there if you wanted to. 156 damage.
It's a little absurd.
I imagine the special attack will also do more damage if you ever get to pull it off again. Which you might in this fight. We didn't even really see how much damage it did last time, it just killed everybody.
Yep.
His blocking animation with the, like, jail bars is pretty good.
Yeah. He's got a lot of, like, amusing cartoony things. Nope, just death. So it did more than 415.
Jeez. And it does that to everybody. That's great for, like, a boss fight that has extra enemies in it, because you can just focus on the boss and then use that to just kill everything else.
And also on the boss, because you'll do a ton of damage.
Right.
Oh, there's a sneaky candy corn kid.
There you go. Now you still need two more.
Oh, there's another vote for the elders.
Well, we are seeing a lot of literal social stratification here. You've got the Crest Whalers at the top, Traubogs, and then the Grubbins at the very bottom.
Mm-hmm.
So is this a voluntary thing? Like, maybe. United States immigrants, you know, forming their own cultures?
They're just their moving. Little, like, ethnic quarters.
I mean, are they allowed to freely travel between them to sample the culture and food of the other people, or are they forced to live in these conditions?
Maybe they're forced to live like this now because the elders aren't in control in power anymore. Yeah, 5 out of 6.
That is true. If you have a triumvirate of the three species working together, they're obviously not going to restrict communication between their own species.
You would hope.
And that'd be kind of a weird thing to agree on.
Pirate hook time!
That's 4 hooks, I think. It'd be 5.
I feel like there was the end of one that was, like, really close to the beginning.
Yeah, I took that one.
Oh, okay.
Don't fall, don't fall, don't fall, don't fall. Oh, that's gonna be it. I don't know if I want to take it yet or if I want to go into the cave first. I'm gonna go into the cave first.
Might be sneaky kids in the cave.
Or, you know, the Yeti everyone's waiting for.
That's true.
Ta-da! I'm a Yeti!
Did you get the Yeti costume?
Yep.
Ah, but the Yeti was a costume all along! Now you get to try out the Yeti powers!
I feel like the washer-dryer in the background there is a reference.
Well, he said he left it in the dryer on high heat. So clearly he needs a dryer to put it in.
Yeah, it's a Yeti!
Whoa.
Is everybody super hyped for the Yeti? With 2 random kids following behind him?
Yep. Yeah, playing hooky.
Alright, only 2 more Chiefs.
One of them, I'm sure, is beat the DLC.
And the other one is
get all the stuff.
Do all the quests.
Yeah. One more kid, three more houses.
I bet the Yeti hits like a truck.
Probably. Maybe. Yes, hot cocoa.
Maybe he's just super spooky.
Yeah, it's trick or treat.
That's funny that he has, like, I assume you could talk to him without being the Yeti, or was that the thing? Like, did you have to go back to him as the Yeti?
I had to go back to him as the Yeti.
Oh, okay. I thought it was just if you got the Yeti to show up, then you could go back and tell him.
Oh, that could be. Because he did just say, oh, you're much smaller in person, but he may not have said that.
Right, that was what I mean. Like, Yeti. It might still let you through, but...
Yeti!
181? Not bad. And...
He's got a lot of health. He has as much health as the unicorn.
True. Abominable armor, that's gonna be a defensive...
Oh, yeah, might not be too bad then. Kind of replaces the ninja ability, if it's a defensive thing. Assuming you can give it to people other than the Yeti.
Yeah, because I really haven't been using the missile attack much. I haven't really been getting to the point where I can use the...
Yeah. By the time you do, they're already dead. And the pirate kind of replaced that anyway.
Yeah.
But like you said, for like boss fights, it's probably good to have a defensive one.
Ooh, but the Yeti armor is all three of them.
Oh, well then, yeah. There you go.
Yep.
Everything gets replaced except for the unicorn. Yeah, so I guess it's like the Night Shield in that it's just a defense up, not a invulnerability. But it's also a team.
It's like the Night one, it's a huge defense boost.
Yeah. And I assume it only lasts for one turn instead of the Knight's two, which would kind of make it a little more balanced. Because again, if it lasts for two, then it's literally just better than the Knight.
I'm pretty sure the rest of the stuff you need is up this way.
Busting up all their Refugian snow dinos.
That's kind of mean.
Easier to change the costume than it is to change the stamps and
yeah, just change the costume back after you hook or whatever.
Insane HP recovery per turn.
Whoa! It's insane.
I might put that on the unicorn when I get to the boss battle.
Right. It's a headless.
All the stamps.
Nope, still one short.
It's probably a quest reward for that mystery quest.
Yeah.
Or for finding the kids, since I don't think you need another bucket.
Maybe. There's a quest. The buckets do give you a damage boost as well.
Yeah, there must be another bucket too, because there's a space for it now, and there didn't used to be in the status screen.
Oh. Well then. Stupid inventories spoiling things.
Yep. Also, none of the costumes I'm currently wearing has any negatives, which is nice.
Yeah. Like when you're playing an RPG and, like, you can clearly see in the party screen that there's room for, like, two more characters or something, and you're like, well...
Right.
Guess we're getting more people.
You're playing a Tales game and you watch the intro video?
Yeah.
I got a Yeti tote.
I feel like a lot of... Ooh, nice. I feel like a lot of RPGs do that. If you watch the opening cinematic, it usually shows you who all of the party members are. Kind of just
spoils
it. And
who the bad guy is, which in a game like that is usually a mystery at the beginning.
Yeah, or like is actually a good guy, but then he's really a bad guy or something.
Just gotta do the last of trick-or-treating and beat the boss.
I believe so. How are you doing on time?
It's 9:30.
Okay.
You should finish right on a good time.
That poison is doing 57 a turn now.
Yeah, I feel like it's proportional to the... Well, actually, no, because you did get the better one, right?
Yeah.
That hit did like over half of the unicorn's health and set her on fire. Or him, I guess.
These are the last three houses.
Caramold.
Sweet wet wheat.
Yep. Why? That one just seems weird. I like caramold at least makes sense. It's like, oh, it's a caramel, but it's like, ew, gross, Halloween, you know, like, kind of a thing. Sweet wet wheat is like, what is, like, a thing of wheat, a candy. Is that like the opposite of like Rice Krispies? Is that what that's supposed to be? Instead of like crispy rice, it's sweet wet wheat, so it's like mushy and made of wheat instead of crispy and made of rice. It's the only possible thing I can think of.
I don't think I would have thought of that. Glazed butter cube?
Oh, tasty.
That would sell in the south.
And there were three in a row before that were all just candy. Now these three in a row were all whites. Guess it's only fair. Oh. They're about 50-50.
Well, they have to get you to level 13 or 14 or whatever it was before
yeah.
You get to the boss.
Wouldn't it be amusing if it was just the same things you fought at the beginning, but now you're actually level 14 and can probably do it?
It probably is.
It's probably not the final boss, but...
It was pretty close last time anyway, so I don't think I'm gonna have an issue. They're probably the fight that gives you the stamp.
Maybe. I mean, this one guy in this fight has 1,000 health, so...
Yeah, but he's the same level that the ones at the beginning were. So.
Right, that's what I mean, though. So, like, it probably is likely that you are going to fight them, because these guys are basically them.
Yeah. 399 damage.
Pirate just has to survive long enough to get his cannonball attack off.
I don't think it's too much of a concern. I could put the HP regen on him.
But then he wouldn't have super damage.
Yeah. One. I'm not even gonna do the attack. No.
He's poisoned anyway. Like, he would die regardless. Do the cannonballs on him. Should have done the cannonballs. Would have killed him. Should have just healed and let him die from poison.
Job
no.
Bird.
You don't get to attack.
This is my life now.
What was that one? That one candy for? It was like clorks or something. It was just like a nonsense word.
Yup, clorks! Exclamation point.
The best candy.
So I have
those
all...
are the weird ones. They're just completely made up. Diet. Oh, there's your dietetic marzipan. I forgot about that one.
Ooh, small HP recovery for the whole party is the last stamp.
Oh. That's interesting, because you can put it on anybody and everyone gets it?
Right. It does say small.
Yeah. But you, like, the unicorn can heal one person a lot if need be. It's probably more useful to let everybody heal a little bit. No? Because, like, a lot of the bosses, like, the the boss of the base game had like that splash damage, which would kind of just get negated by that.
Right. I can put that on the unicorn. Leave the double attack power on the pirate and leave the counterattack on Ren. All the quests, all the costumes, all the creepy treats. The only weird thing is I haven't quite hit level 14 yet. I am short 50 experience.
Oh. Well, there must be one more fight somewhere.
Oh, here it is. Found it.
Found it. You did it. Good job.
Or I didn't do math, but it wasn't very much.
No, it... Oh. Yeah, it was like 4...
It was 450.
Oh yeah, and look at this fight. This looks familiar.
Yep. They're like, hey, it's you again. Let's shove him down the hole.
Now you're a yeti and a pirate.
No, I was expecting the splash damage there. I forgot I just unequipped that. Unequipped or dequipped?
Yes.
Oh, wow, it heals a decent amount though. 80 and 64.
Ooh, nice.
So it's gonna be a percentage.
Right. But yeah, that's good. That's like over half of the damage that you took, so... And again, if the boss has like a big AoE attack or something, that'll be useful.
Yeah.
So you're being smart with your attacks.
Yeah.
Not wasting the pirate on like someone that's almost dead.
Yeah. He can do 400, especially before when I had the splash damage. Okay, now we can finally see how much this does.
Sure about that?
It only said 215 that time.
Maybe these guys have like super defense.
They might.
It killed the other guy, though.
Right, but he had less health.
Did he?
I wonder if that when it matters who you target.
Maybe. Maybe it does do a ton of damage to one person, and still quite a bit to everybody else.
And checking the menu.
Yeah.
Yeah. Eight cod. Yeah, level up, and that's max level.
That gave you way more XP than you needed.
Yeah, it did.
Oh my god, yes.
Also, the description for the pirate is fantastic. This says cannon fire damaging all enemies. I wonder if it's very variable.
Maybe. Yarr!
Yarr!
Alright, anything else I need to do?
Nope, just gotta beat the last boss and do the last quest.
Your bag looks kind of boring now. Doesn't have the little bat wings on the side or anything, it's just a big bag.
Just a tote bag.
Yeah. It doesn't have like a little... I mean, the actual bag that they're carrying has like a little yeti face on it or something, I think. But the icon in the corner is just kind of a normal looking bag.
I don't think you need any more candy.
You always need all the candy.
Not gonna stop you or anything, but...
They're running away. Oh no, he's back! It's the same boss!
Those things can fly?
maybe just that one can fly.
I mean, they are like bird monsters.
No. See, this is why you're evil.
But he's using his candy taxes to bring Big Bones back to full health.
Yeah, it's public health care.
He'll be able to crush the candy out of the universe. Like some kind of candy crush.
Taking down? Oh, yes, I was correct. It's you again, except now your eyeballs make slightly more sense. Cannot target Big Bones.
Hey, he's just chilling in the back.
I mean, he's way over there.
He's like in the sauna. Oh no, now he's a little more aggressive.
And he's now he's not.
And yeah, the splash damage would not be helpful here.
Yeah. It might do like a little bit of splash, but auto healing for the party, on the other hand, really good.
Yeah, it is. Oh, he's flying. I guess he's in phase two.
Got a nat 20 in the face.
I'm gonna take this advantage to use the armor.
Oh, Big Bones doing the jazz hands.
Oh. That was a waste.
Yeah, you just need to smack him now.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter with what.
But if I had held on to the pirate, yeah, it'll come back. It only takes like two or three turns.
Three turns.
Good job. Jazz hands. And everybody's basically staying at full health.
Yeah. Especially with that Yeti barrier. Well, I guess it does stay for... Oh no, that was the counter. Does the Yeti barrier... Oh, no, yeah, Yeti barrier goes away. One turn.
But still.
Yeah, yeah, it's good if there's a big AoE attack incoming. Which is nice.
Yeah, now he's taken...
Ow. That hurt.
It's fine.
He'll live.
Yeah. Yeah, stop freaking out.
I want 27, it's not all that much. Bad. Okay, that's a lot.
Vomited all that candy all over you.
Okay, now.
Really?
So now you can commence the regular smackdown. Somebody get dead.
Not quite.
You don't want your own people to get dead. Oh.
I mean, the pirate's already pre-dead.
Pre-dead.
Yeah.
You do have another armor ready, though.
Just use it.
Clearly, we should have swapped the unicorn back out for Lady Liberty for this final battle. I'm not sure. I guess pushing him back just like stops him from doing whatever he's gonna do when he's flying, and makes him vulnerable again.
Yeah, I think it just makes him vulnerable.
Because it's not like him landing on Big Bones' head like does anything to either of them. Oh, I guess Big Bones is about to attack, I think, because he's like stood up now and doing the jazz hands.
Yeah.
So that would have been a good time for, yeah.
He did the jazz hands for 2 turns, so I used his turn early. Everett's dead, but I have Unicorn, so.
Oh yeah, that rezzes. I kind of forgot that that actually rezzes. As long as Unicorn does not die.
Live, Unicorn! Live!
It's also a full res.
Right.
So, he's starting jazz hands now, so I'm gonna wait a... not use the armor this turn.
Yeah, I guess?
I mean, you're probably gonna kill him this turn, so...
Probably.
Oh, maybe not. Oh no.
Well, no.
She can probably kill Araxia, but...
Yeah, and that'll start phase 2 of the fight.
It never gives you the satisfaction of them going down to 0. They always go down to 1 health.
And
he uses it this turn. What the hell? Don't know what you want. And he still has 1 health. What the...
I think now you just have to shove him back all the way. Now that he's at 1 health.
Probably.
And then he, like, falls into his mouth or something.
Now you're jazz handing again. I don't understand the cycle of this. I'm gonna get smacked when he comes back from that.
Well, I think pushing the bird into him does knock him down.
But you can only do that if the bird is in the air.
Oh, you're right, he's not in the air anymore. That's weird.
Yeah. He, like, landed. Oh, the counterattack did actually push him back, though. And then... well, crap. I guess the one benefit of having the unicorn on Ren is that the other turns haven't passed already.
That's true.
Okay, so he's doing the jazz hands. Do I use the armor?
I would say yeah.
If the bird's on the ground, use the armor.
I think last time maybe he did the jazz hands, you smacked the bird into him, which like delayed it a turn, and then he jazz hands did it again. And did the candy, that's why you thought he was doing it for 2 turns.
Maybe.
I think the tell is that when he does the jazz hands, he's going to do the super attack. And now you need the unicorn to live.
My graphics are not happy. Are they looking stuttery?
A little bit, yeah.
Which is weird, because it was fun.
Yeah, it might just be the particle effect again, because there's all the, like, ghosts and...
Yeah, but, like, it was fine for the rest of this whole fight. It just, like, all of a sudden...
See, now he's jazz-handsing again, and I don't have
and you
the
can't,
armor back.
Yeah. I think you got, like, thrown off of the... pattern at some point.
Yeah,
and having
because...
something dead doesn't help either.
Right, well, now that he's dead, I can only hit him twice in 1 turn.
Yeah, exactly. And yeah, there's like not much you can do, because like you could bring Everett back, but then the unicorn might die.
Yep, that's what happened.
Yeah. And now you can't bring unicorn back.
Right.
Part of me wonders if Lady Liberty might actually be more useful here. Although I guess if you're armoring up every round of Jazz Hands, it's not that big of a deal. But like the party heal might actually be more useful.
Yeah. He's got a lot less health though.
Yeah. Well, we don't really know exactly how much, because you do get health from leveling up. So like level 14, Lady Liberty will have more health than Lady Liberty did before, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's like impossible. I don't think I can.
He's doing it like every other turn now, and it's like you can't possibly.
Yeah, and I haven't been able to push the bird back because I've only had two of them.
Yeah. I feel like you just got stuck in a bad situation.
Give it another go.
Do you think I'd change anything, or do you think I'd leave it?
What do you have? You have attack up. What do you have on? You still have the counterattack on him?
I have the counterattack on Ren.
What you could do is give the unicorn the high regen for herself, and then give the robot the party health up, so that unicorn is getting like tons of health every turn to stay alive and res the others as needed.
Right.
Or like you said, swap the outfits so that the first person is the unicorn, and when they res, the other people still get to take their turn. Which would basically be swap unicorn onto Ren and then give Ren the massive health regen stamp.
Why would switching them do anything?
Because like you said, then when you res someone, the resed person would still get to take their turn after the unicorn. You said that before.
I did. Definitely want Yeti, definitely want Pirate.
Yeah, I feel like the costume composition is solid.
Insane HP recovery per turn. Leave the double attack power on Everett.
Yeah, and then the Yeti is basically your, like, passive support defense. Because
right.
It has the party regen and the defensive special. That should work.
I think that's right now.
Yeah.
Right. Oh no, everybody needs to run by again.
And now you know the Jazz Hands thing, so you won't get caught off guard by, like, the first one.
Right, assuming I don't smack the bird into him again.
Right, yeah, I don't know exactly how that works. I think it's basically if you can hit the bird into him, then you don't need to do the Yeti thing, just smack the bird into him. Which I think is what you're supposed to do.
Right.
I think maybe that's what it is. I think maybe he Jazz Hands, like, every other turn or every, like, a little faster than you could build up your special. But every other one of those, you're supposed to be knocking the bird into him. You get what I mean?
Right. Yeah, but the thing is, if I use the...
When you go, when you get off cycle, then you can't stop them with the bird, and then you get hit twice and die.
Right, because if I use the...
Yeti armor.
If I use the Yeti armor, then I only have two attacks, and then it's not enough to push the bird, and then it goes back.
Right. So if the bird's in the air, you just push him in, and it cancels the Big Bones attack.
Yeah.
And then when he goes to do it again, then you use the Yeti, because the bird won't be in the air again.
Right.
And then I think it should alternate like that. And it was just that once one person died, you couldn't push the bird in, and so you were getting hit by both things, or you couldn't build up the Yeti fast enough. And
Taking down.
Jokes.
The only minor flaw in this plan would be if the two regens don't stack, but I kind of assume they will.
You have to imagine they would.
Even then, you're going to get enough regen from the big one that if it doesn't get the small one, it's not a huge deal.
I suppose the other flaw would be if even rezzing them with the first person still doesn't give them their turn because they were dead when the round started. I don't know how that actually works.
Pretty sure we've seen it that they get their turns. I believe we have seen that.
I feel like I always had the unicorn at the end of the line, though. But maybe like the first time when we got unicorn.
Yeah, you might have had it on. $492 damage. Jeez.
Alright, so he's jazz handing and the bird's in the air.
So I think just hit the bird.
Let's hit the bird.
With the whole party.
Yeah, now I don't have the counter. The counter would actually push the bird back too. Okay, and that time I only had to hit him twice.
Because you hit him once at the end of the last
round. Okay, yeah, and then he stops jazz handing.
He gets knocked over by the bird and does not get his candy.
Yeah, because that's what it is, when the candy falls into his mouth enough times, then he...
Now he's jazz handing, but the bird is on the ground.
So that's when you're going to want to use the Yeti shield.
Okay.
Because I think it takes 3 hits to knock the bird in. So
right.
Even if like he flew up on like one of the on like the final attack or something, it still wouldn't be enough to shove another one in.
Right.
Cat wants to help stream.
Helpful cat.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, and then they'll also regen most of that anyway. Jeez, 219 regen. Pony will never die.
Pony is eternal.
Jazz hands, birds in the air.
You already hit him twice.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can just punch him right in. Could punch him in with the unicorn, right? And then, like, use the ship attack?
Maybe.
Well, I don't think you kill the bird through damage.
Well, but it'll get him down to 1 faster.
Yeah.
$623 damage. And on fire.
What if the fire would push him back?
Oh, that'd be interesting.
He doesn't stay on fire for very long, and he just healed himself.
It's just one turn.
Jazz hands and on the ground, so now I'm yetiing.
Yes. See, I think now...
Kill it.
Yeah, now it's like perfectly timed. You're still at like completely full health.
Yeah.
Yep.
So you needed a learner game to figure it out.
Yeah. That's pretty standard. To, like,
it's not
learn
that bad.
Patterns.
Especially because you just, like, it just throws you back out right outside the fight. It's not like you have to load a save or anything.
Yeah.
In games where it kicks you all the way back to a save point or something, then it's usually more like it tries to let you learn it without murdering you immediately, but...
Right.
You're not quite at full health. 11 points shy.
Close enough.
Oh, I made him angry. Oh, and then he... Oh, wait, what?
Yeah, that's it.
I thought I was gonna have to fight Big Bones. Yay!
You already fought Big Bones.
True. Double G power!
I think you essentially fought Big Bones by denying him his candy enough times, so then he just dissolved into the goop.
Right. It's kind of interesting that he had a health bar then.
Yeah, it is a little weird.
Daw.
Yes, buddy, you can help stream too.
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea, Reynolds. Oh no! Oh god. Getting out of here. Yeah, that newspaper is super detailed. Oh god. So many portals. I don't even know how you get to- Oh, that's just- Well then. The end, question mark?
Bum bum bum!
That was really abrupt.
Yep.
Well, they're just stuck in portal hell now.
Custom Quest 2 will answer none of those questions.
I was gonna say, sounds like a sequel hook, but there was actually a sequel.
That didn't hang on that hook.
And now we get what I think is the same credits.
Yeah, I just hit the escape button.
Probably a good plan.
You did it.
Yay, you beat a game.
Beat the whole game.
Beat the game and got all the achievements.
We gotta play on Christmas.
I did that. Off stream.
Oh. Okay.
I changed my system time. So it says play Costume Trap. Quest on Christmas, unlocked October 25th.
Peter. Cheating. It's cheating. It doesn't count.
Yep, I'm gonna go into the Steam Achievement Manager and delete it.
And report you.
The Steam Police.
Get VAC banned from Costume Quest.
Yep.
Because you've never done that.
No. Okay, good night, everybody.
Thanks for watching.